Over 100 million years ago, during the early Cretaceous period, there lived a monster known as Kronosaurus, a 30-foot-long marine reptile that you definitely wouldn't want to cross paths with in the ocean. It was not a dinosaur, but a relative of the pliosaur, a group of large marine reptiles. Kronosaurus is believed to have gone extinct at the same time as the dinosaurs, but what if it didn't? What if it lived on until modern day? That's exactly what we're going to talk about right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. This is where I ask you to leave a like, subscribe, and let us know in the comments below a question you have always wanted to know the answer to. We'll do our best to answer it in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions. Back in 1899, a man named Andrew Crombie found a scrap of bone containing 6 conical teeth. He gave the fossil to the Queensland Museum. A quarter of a century later, the director of the Queensland Museum at the time, Herbert Longman, declared that the fossil belonged to a previously unheard of species, which he called Kronosaurus queenslandicus. More fossils that belonged to Kronosaurus were then discovered. Kronosaurus was named after the father of Zeus, the Greek god Cronus, and for good reason. It is one of the biggest and most deadly marine reptiles to ever have existed. Kronosaurus was gargantuan, at least 30 feet from end to end. It had a long head, short neck, 4 flippers, and a short tail. Kronosaurus was a carnivore, and its mouth was decked out with many long teeth. Fossils put these teeth at least 3 inches in length, some were up to 12 inches. Interestingly, apparently Kronosaurus's teeth were not that sharp, at least not in comparison with other marine reptiles and prehistoric sharks. That doesn't mean, however, that it wouldn't suck to end up in its mouth. Kronosaurus made up for its blunt teeth with an extremely powerful bite and swimming capabilities. Kronosaurus's flippers allowed it to swim extremely fast, making it difficult for prey to escape it. Once Kronosaurus had its prey in its jaw, it violently shook it, and then its powerful bite could snap the shell of a giant turtle as easily as an eggshell. Rather than eat giant squids and fish, Kronosaurus liked to munch on its fellow marine reptiles, as well as plesiosaurs, a long-necked, warm-blooded creature that ate mostly fish and cephalopods. Kronosaurus's habitat was not only near Australia. Close to complete fossil specimens were found in Colombia, a country that has a rich history of huge, prehistoric snakes, turtles, and crocodiles. One can then infer that its habitat likely extended worldwide. The Kronosaurus may have also inhabited the western United States because most of that area was covered by a shallow body of water during the early Cretaceous period. It isn't exactly certain why Kronosaurus went extinct. It was partially because its species was under threat from sharks, as well as a new species of marine reptiles, mosasaurs. And then when a 15-kilometer wide asteroid struck the Earth 66 million years ago, they went completely extinct. But what if they didn't? What would it mean for other marine life and human life on Earth? Let's say that somehow Kronosaurus survived the devastating impact of the meteor when most other large marine creatures didn't. It would have been extremely difficult for Kronosaurus to survive the Ice Age. Back when it roamed the seas, the Earth was at least 8 degrees hotter than it is now. For this reason, Kronosaurus would have only been able to stand waters near the equator. Perhaps it would have adapted to these cooler temperatures by developing thick, blubbery skin. If Kronosaurus lived until modern day, its brain may have evolved to be relatively intelligent. Perhaps not as intelligent as humans, but definitely smart. And because it became so smart, it would have been an expert at finding and killing prey. Since Kronosaurus loved to prey on other marine life, it's likely that sharks, whales, and porpoises would have been its favorite snacks. Perhaps larger marine life would cease to exist as we know it. The mass extinction that occurred 66 million years ago made way for mammals. Without it, many of the creatures that exist today simply wouldn't. And that definitely goes for large marine life. It can be assumed that perhaps the only type of marine life to flourish would be fish, cephalopods, and smaller mammals, and sharks, that could easily hide from Kronosaurus. Maybe creatures like dolphins would have evolved to be much smaller than we know them to be, and would have had to create protective places and dens to keep away from Kronosaurus. That being said, another type of animal would have preyed on it. Humans. Humans would have added them to their menu, and since Kronosaurus may have existed in all parts of the globe, one can assume that many different cultures would have hunted them. This definitely wouldn't have been easy, but specifically crafted weapons would have been invented. That being said, Kronosaurus would have made sea travel extremely difficult. A 30-foot-long carnivorous marine reptilian would make any sane person avoid a boat trip. If Kronosaurus didn't go extinct, it may have affected trade routes as well as explorers to the New World. Rough seas were already difficult enough for explorers. Imagine having to deal with Kronosaurus as well. Maybe many areas of the globe would remain undiscovered for this reason. What do you think would happen if Kronosaurus didn't go extinct? Let us know in the comments below. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre, and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you enjoyed this video, you'll love our playlist, Biggest What Ifs, clickable on the screen right now. And don't forget to turn on those notifications by clicking the bell, and we'll see you in another video.